In this tutorial, I'll show you how easy it is to use camera tracking and attach some graffiti-style objects to a wall. Hi, my name is Manuel. I'm a freelance motion designer. You want to make sure your version of After Effects is the latest, as we're going to use new tapered shape strokes for our graphic objects later in the tutorial. This is my comp, 3 seconds long with our footage. It's a young lady walking along a wall, leaving behind blue paint, which we want to bring to life and add graphics to it. So first of all, we open the tracker, either here on the right side or up here by selecting Track Camera in the animation menu. You want to select Detail Analysis for better results, which might take a bit longer. This blue stripe means After Effects is analyzing the scene, 10 seconds later, recreating the camera movement, and here we go, the result, lots of tracking points attached to the wall. Which is great, as we want to attach stuff to the wall. If you move your mouse over these points, you'll see that red target appear on the screen. Let's find a position where the target looks perfectly round, meaning it looks directly into the camera, maybe here. We click on it to fix the position. Then we right-click on it and select Create Solid and Camera. Two new layers appear in the timeline, a 3D camera and a track solid. The solid is moving with the wall, so we can use it as a null object for all our graphics. We could have created a null as well, by the way, instead of a solid. Next, we add a shape layer, name it Strokes. Make it a 3D layer and link it to the track solid. We need to open the position property and set all values back to 0. Now it has the exact same position. Actually, we don't need to see the solid. We select the shape layer, click on the fill up here while holding Option until the fill is turned off. Then we choose the pen tool, select the shape layer and draw kind of a curly path, starting somewhere in the blue paint, moving upwards. By pressing V, we choose the selection tool to adjust the points. Let's change the stroke width to around 105 pixels. We open up all the shape properties and first of all set the line cap to round. And here's a new thing called taper. We open it, set the end length to 100, making this upper part of the shape thinner and thinner. And let's set the end width to 25%, which I feel like thickens the middle part again. Awesome. Let's do some compositing. We need to change the color. Why not add a gradient ramp? For the end color, we pick the blue paint. Move the endpoint right here below the path. And for the beginning, we choose a brighter color and set the start point just above the path. Alright, let's add roughen edges to break up the borders of the shape. Set the scale to around 25, the border to 4. And let's reduce the complexity to 1. Then we reduce the opacity to around 85% to let the background shine through a little bit. I made a paint texture in Photoshop, which is basically black and white paint strokes and splatters. To make the shapes even more look like they were painted, let's add this texture. Make it a 3D layer, link it to the track solid, reset the position to 0. Let's scale it bigger, as it needs to cover all the area where our graphics will be. Then we turn it into the luma mat for the strokes layer. Now it has these little fractures in the shape, like the paint on the wall. Last thing we'll do is activate motion blur here in the timeline. Now let's add more strokes to the wall as she walks along. by simply duplicating the shapes within the layer and adjusting the path.
Music! Next, let's quickly animate one of these tentacles.
We add trim paths just to the shape, not the whole layer, and set the end value to 0, then to 100. Timing-wise, when the path moves out of the scene, it should be completed. Finally, we add easy ease in to the end point. Repeat that with the other paths as well. Now it's your turn. Add more stuff. Go crazy. This is what I finally came up with. See how that last shape is coming after her? I thought this interaction is kind of funny. What do y'all think? Let me know in the comments below. On the left side, I've added some videos you might like. Subscribe to my channel on the right side and ring the bell if you want to know exactly when the next video is coming out. Thanks so much for watching. Hope that tutorial was useful for y'all. See you next time, guys. Bye!